Hi Leo, so right now we are going to do it for you. This time I have come up with a different topic, like sometimes my mind says something, my heart says something, I do have a lot of fear all about. So I have taken this as a questions for each zodiac sign. So I'm going to predict for what does your mind says, what does your heart says, what is the fear is all about, and what is the positive outcome, and what is the advice. And I'm going to do one more card with based on moonology cards, which will guide you what is that you want to do, what is it, whether you have to follow the dreams or not. It will give you a guidance with a sentence like, work through your fears, have faith in your dreams. So a kind of guidance we can get from the oracle cards. Yes, if you're very new to my channel, kindly do subscribe, like, share, and subscribe. And if you want to take a personal reading, there is a link in the description box which will direct you to my Instagram page. If not, there is my WhatsApp number over there. You can ping me and you can book your personal readings. Personal readings are chargeable. Personal readings will be based on your name and date of birth. I'll be doing it so that you can get accurate readings based on your name and date of birth. So thank you so much in advance. And without any delay, let's begin. It's a general reading. It may or may not resonate. Take what resonates with you. Okay, let's start. Let's initially find out what does your mind says, and what does your heart says, and what is your fear is about. Initially, we'll do that. Okay, Leo. What does your mind says? What does your mind says? It could be about, it's a general one. It can be about your relationship, it can be about a particular situation, family or friendship, or you know, about a job, career. Okay, no, I'm sorry, my bad, my cards totally fell down. Okay, what does your mind says for you? What does your mind says? What does your mind says? Two cards, please. What does your mind says? Your mind says, you know, it is, the cards is High Priestess and the Death. A new cycle is about to begin. Something is going to end for sure. Your mind believes in that something is going to end very, very, very soon. And it's even suggesting you to believe in your intuition, because I'm getting a Death card and also a Rebirth card, which is telling me this upcoming days, or, you know, the days which you're going to face, it's going to be either going to be a new one or it's going to be a rebirth for you. Okay, let's clarify that. But before that let's see what does your heart says. Two cards, please. What does your heart says? Your heart says, your heart is very brave right now. It believes in itself. And the Ace of Swords, your heart believes in success and victory and breakthrough. Let's find out your fear. What's your fear is all about? Two cards, please. What is your fear is all about? Two cards, please. Maybe it's about a burden. You are unable to take any decisions, stuck between something. You cannot take a proper decisions right now. That is what your fear is all about. I could see that clearly, but let's clarify with the cards before. Let's take out some oracle cards for you. One card, please. What is it you want to say for Leo people? What is it you want to say for Leo people? Adjustments are required. it's suggesting you to, you need to adjust for certain circumstances or certain situations, or you need to undergo some adjustment based on your behavior or based on your habits. It's suggesting you to adjust. It's suggesting like there are adjustments that, and this is very required right now for you. Let's clarify for about your mind. Okay, why the High Priestess is here? Why the High Priestess is here for Leo? Why the High Priestess is here for Leo? Oh, God's please for clarification. Why the Death card is here for Leo? Why the Death card is here for Leo? I feel like you have drained or you've been exhausted. Is that so? Yeah. I feel like, you know, at the two cards, see, death is clarified by the Knight of Pentacles and the Eight of Cups, which is also High Priestess is clarified by the Ten of Wands and the Six of Cups, which is telling me you're not. These two cards, which is clearly showing me that you are fed up, you're exhausted. Your mind is so much exhausted. Your mind is so much fed up, so much disappointed, so much abandoned. You feel like you need a break. You feel like there is so much on your shoulders right now. And things are going very, very slow. It's not happening based on what you think. So this is what I could predict it, which is telling me you're so much exhausted. Your mind is very much exhausted, very disappointed. It's very much disappointed. It feels like it's so abandoned. Things are not moving in your way. Even if it's so, like, it's not happening. Things are happening very slow. Let's predict what does your heart says. Why the Queen of Wands is here? Clarify me with the two cards. You can resonate with your relationship, with your job, or with a particular situation. Okay. What does your heart says? Why the Queen of Wands is here? You feel like you completely need rest. You want to take a break. You want to go somewhere. I feel like you're also with the Death card suggesting me, like, you know, and also the Rebirth, which is telling me maybe some of the people are entering into the spiritual world. They are spiritual basically, but you're showing your interest based on your situation. You know, you're too much into it and you want a break. And at the same time, I feel like some people are moving towards spirituality. Exhausted. Total exhausted people. But your heart says definitely it needs time, because because your heart could not fetch some hidden facts within you or with the situation, so it feels like it won't rest. Why the Ace of Swords is here? Why the Ace of Swords is here? One more card, please. Why the Ace of Swords is here? You're clearly grieving, you're exhausted, or you won't know, because Ace of Swords is clarified by the Five of Cups and the Chariot, which is telling me, like, you know, still, You feel like you have lost, you need a break, you're grieving, but still you're moving forward. You're just moving towards your victory. Still you want to win. Still you want to lead. But you're very strong. You're a very strong person. You believe in that things have gone beyond your hands, which you cannot control. You believe in justice too. Once again. Clearly, I could see, like, you know, there are three cards which are showing me you need rest, or, you know, like, you feel disappointed, you feel so exhausted, you feel like you need a break, or you need to come out of particular circumstance very soon. You feel so stuck. Why the Two of Swords is here? Why the Two of Swords is here? Because you can't let go of from your hands. I think you're just holding it. You cannot take decisions. At the same time, you're not ready to give up. That is your biggest fear. You're not ready to give up. You don't want to give up. And you, at the same time, you cannot take any decisions. You don't want anything, something new. And you want the old one, and you want to hold about your old stuff or old person, or could be anyone. I feel like things will change. Why the Page of Pentacles is here? I think you are not adjusting. Adjustments are required in the sense your mind adjustments are much more required over here right now. Why the Page of Pentacles is here? Yes, a lot of adjustments is required. You need to wait patiently. Okay, don't be so desperate. If you are, things will definitely change for sure, because if things are happening in front, if it is happening behind, we cannot do any kind of control. That control is not in our hands. The fear is, yeah, no clarity, lots of opportunity. You are stuck whether to choose this or that. Many things are running in your mind, many things are happening around you. Is that why I feel like you're so much exhausted or so frustrated, so much disappointed? You need a break. What's a positive outcome of the situation? What's a positive outcome of the situation? You will get a break. You will get a break. With the proper person. If it is about a relationship, you will meet a person very, very soon. You will end up with a person very soon whom you are looking for it. If you are looking for a particular person, you're worrying about a person in your life, the person will be there in your life for sure. What's a piece of advice you want to give? What's a piece of advice you want to give? One card advice, please, for Leo. You can make it happen. Adjustments are required. You can make it happen. Everything is in your hands. Don't feel stuck. Take some risk. risk are worth of your life. Don't get fear, don't get stuck, take a proper decisions, don't get confused. You will end up with the person you love. If not, if you are so exhausted, you will get a break for sure. Things are going to happen on your favor if you want to make it happen. If you are surrounded yourself by the negative things, yes, you will manifest only the negativity. You have everything that advises. If you want to make it happen, yes, you can do it. Do have some adjustments in your life. Things will change for sure. Thank you all so much. Let's all spread only love.